Out of here.
My men are not going back.
Out of my sight. Out of my sight. What shall I tell them? That my daughter and my niece I discovered dancing like heathen in the forest?
Uncle, we did dance. Like you told them I confessed it and I'll be whipped if I must, but speaking of witchcraft, Betty's not witched.
Abigail, I cannot go before the congregation when I know you have not opened with me. And what did you do with her in the forest?
We danced, and when you left in on us, she took fright and fainted. That's the whole of it.
Child, sit you down.
I would never hurt Betty. I love her dearly.
Now look, you child, your punishment will come in its time. But if you traffic with spirits in the forest, then I must know it. For surely my enemies will, and they will ruin me with it.
Never conjure the spirits, Uncle.
Why can she not move herself since midnight? This child is desperate. It must come out. My enemies will bring this out, Abigail. Do you understand that I have many enemies?
I have heard it, Uncle.
There is a faction here that has sworn to drive me from my pulpit. Do you understand that? Now then, in the midst of such disruption, my own household is discovered to be the very center of some obscene practices. Abominations are done in the forest. You call this sport? Abigail, if you know something that may help the doctors, for God's sake, tell it to me. I saw Tituba. She was waving her arms over the fire when I came upon you. Why was she doing that? I could hear screeching and gibberish coming from her mouth. She was swaying like a dumb beast over that fire.
Well, she sings her barbet of songs and we dance.
I cannot blink what I saw, Abigail. My enemies will not blink it. I saw a dress in the grass.
A dress?
Aye, a dress. I thought I saw someone naked running.
No,
through
she
the
was naked. Uncle,
I saw saying it. Now you tell me true, Abigail, and I pray you feel the weight of truth upon you. For my ministry's at stake. My ministry and perhaps my cousin's life. Whatever abominations you've done in the forest, let me know. I dare not be taken unaware when I go before them down there. Is there any other reason than what you have told me for your being discharged from Goody Proctor's services? For I've heard it said, and I tell you as I've heard it, that she comes so rarely to church this year that she dare not sit next to something soiled. What signified that remark?
Why, she hates me. She must. I would not be her slave. She is a bitter, sniffing lying woman, and I would not work for such a woman.
She may be, but yet it has troubled me that you are now 7 months out of their house, and not one family has called for your service.
They want slaves, not such as I. Let them send the barbados with that. I will not blacken my face for any of them. You begrudge my medical.
No. No.
My name is Quinn in the village. I would not have it said in the soil. Goody Proctor is a gossiping liar.
No, no. I cannot have anybody place it. Why Goody Putnam? Hello.
It is a marvel. There's surely a sort of hell upon you.
No, no. It is.
How high did she fly? How high?
No, no. She never flew, Goody.
Why, sure she did. Mr. Collins saw her going over Ingersoll's barn and come down light as a bird, he says.
Now look, you Goody Ann. She never flew, and that was just a... Good morning, Mr. Putnam.
Why, it's a providence. The thing is up now.
It is a providence.
What is, sir?
Look, you man. Her eyes is closed.
That's strange. Her nose is open.
Your Ruth, she is
sick. I do not call it sick, for the devil's touch is heavier than sick. It's death, you know. Death driving into the forked and hoof. But hurry not.
Why, how does your Ruth ail?
She ails as she must. She never woke this morning as she walks. She sees not and hears not and cannot eat. Her soul is taken, surely.
I've heard you sent for Reverend Hale of Beverly.
No, only as a precaution, Mr. Putnam. See, Reverend Hale has all good experience in all demonic arts.
Indeed she has, and found a witch in Beverly last year, let you remember that.
Only what they thought were a witch could he had, and I'm sure there is no elements of witchcraft here in Savage.
Now we hear, Mr. Paris. I will not take...
Aunt Thomas, I pray you, do not lead to witchcraft. They will hound me out of Salem for such corruption in my home.
Now look here, Mr. Paris. I've taken your part in all contention. But I will not continue if you hold back against me. Fair and vengeful. Hurtful spirits lay hands on these children.
Don't you understand it, Sir Thomas?
And tell him what you've done.
Mr. Paris, I have laid 7 babies unbaptized in the earth. Believe me, sir, you never saw more hardy babies born, and yet each would shrivel in my hands on the night of their birth. I have spoken nothing, but my heart has clamored intimations. And now my Ruth, my only, I see her turning strange. A secret child she has become, and shrivels like a sucking mouth when pulling on her life, too. And so I thought to send her to your Tituba.
My Tituba? What made Tituba?
Tituba knows how to speak to the dead, Mr. Paris.
Goody Aunt, it is a formidable sin to conjure up the dead.
I take not my soul, but who has made surely tell me who murdered my babies?
Woman!
It were murder, Mr. Paris, and mark this as proof. Mark it. Last night my Ruth were ever so close to her little spirits. I know it, sir. For how else is she struck dumb now, except some power of darkness should stop her mouth?
Don't you understand it, sir? There's a murdering witch among us that's bound to keep herself in the dark. Let your enemies make of it what they will. But you cannot blink it!
Then you were conjuring spirits last night.
Not I, sir. It's friend Ruth.
Oh, Abigail. What proper repayment for my charity? Now I am undone!
No, you're not undone. Let you take hold of it. Wait for nobody to declare it upon you. Declare it to yourself. You have discovered witchcraft.
Thomas! In my house! They will talk of me with this. They will make of it!
I only thought to see how Betty is.
Why aren't you home? Who's with Ruth?
Her grandmother come. She's improved a little, I think. She gave a powerful sneeze earlier.
The sign of what?
I fear no more, Goody Putnam. It were a grand sneeze, another like it will shake her wits together, I'm sure.
Thomas, will you leave me now? I would pray a while alone.
Uncle, you've prayed since midnight. I think it'd be best to go down and...
No. I have no answer for that crowd. I will wait till Reverend Hale arrives. If you will, Goody Aunt.
Now look here, Mr. Paris. Let you strike out against the devil, and the village will bless you for it. Go down there. Speak with them. Pray with them. They're thirsting for your word, mister. Surely you will pray with them.
I will lead them in a psalm, but let you speak nothing of witchcraft yet. The cause is yet unknown. I have had enough contention since I've come, and I will have no more.
Mercy, go to Ruth now, do you hear?
She starts for the window, you cry for me at once.
I will.
There is a terrible power in her arms today.
How is Ruth sick? Weirdish, I know not. She walks like a dead one since last night. Betty. Betty, stop this now. Betty! Have you tried beating her? I gave my Ruth a good one, and it seemed to wake her for a second. Here, let me have her.
No.
We danced.
I told him that much already.
Aye, what more?
He knows Tituba conjured Ruth's dead sisters.
And what more?
He saw you naked.
Jesus! What do we do? The village is out. I just come from the farm. The whole country's talking witchcraft. They'll be calling us witches, Abby.
They'll be calling us witches, Abby!
She needs to tell, I know it.
We've got to tell. Witchery's a hanging error. Hanging like they done in Boston 2 years ago? Abby, we must tell the truth. You'll only be whipped for dancing.
You will be whipped.
I've never done any of it, Abby. I only looked.
Oh, you're a great one for looking, aren't you, Mary Warren? What a grand peeping courage you have.
Betty.
Betty, it's Abigail. I'll beat you, Betty! I already told your papa everything. There's no need to do any-
You did!
with the edge of a word, and I will come to you in the blackness of terrible night with a pointy reckoning that will shudder you. You know I can do it. I've seen some wretched work done at night, and I wish you would never see the sun go down. Now, Ben, sit up and stop this.
I've got her.
Abby, she's going to die. It's a sin.
I'm gonna shut it, Mary Warren.
Mary Warren, be you deaf? I have forbid you to leave the house, have I not? What shall I pay you for? I'm looking for you more often than my cows.
I only come to see the great doings in the world.
I'll show you a great doing on your arse one of these days. Now get you home. My wife's waiting with your work.
You better be off. I have my room to look after. Good morning, Mr. Proctor.
Pilgrimage to Salem all morning. Town's mumble and witchcraft.
Oh, posh. We danced in the woods and my uncle left in on us. She took fright, is all.
You're a wicked one yet, aren't you? You'll be collapsing the stocks before you're 20.
Give me a word, John. Soft word.
No. No, Abby, that's done with.
Surely you've been 5 minutes to see us literally go fly.
I've come to see what Mission of Yard was brewing up now. You put it out of mind, Abby.
John, I'm waiting for you every night.
I give you no hope to wait for me.
You have something better than hope, I think.
You put it out of mind, Abby. I'll not be coming for you more.
You're surely sporting with me.
You know me better.
I know how you clutch my back behind your house. How you sweat like a stallion whenever I come near you. Or did I dream it? It was she who put me out. You could not pretend it was you. I saw your face when she put me out. You loved me then, just as you do now.
Abby, that is a wild thing to say.
A wild thing to say wild things? Well, not so wild, I think. I've seen you since she put me out. I've seen you nights.
I've hardly stepped off my farm in 7 months.
I have sensed her heat, John. And it was just drawing me to my window. You didn't tell me you had never looked up at my window.
I may have looked up.
But you must. You are no wintry man, John. I cannot sleep for dreaming. I cannot dream for awake, and I walk about the house as if waiting for you to come through some door.
Child.
How dare you call me child?
Abby, I may think of you softly from time to time, but I will cut off my hand before I'll ever reach for you again. You'll put it out of mind, Abby. We never touched.
Aye, but we did.
Aye, but we did not.
Oh, how I marvel at such a sweet, strong man I left.
You'll speak nothing of Elizabeth.
She's blackening my name in the village. She's telling lies about me. She's a
You look for a weapon?
I look for the John Proctor that took me out of my bed and put knowledge in my heart. I never knew what pretend Salem was. I never knew what lying lessons I was taught by these Christian women and these covenanted men. Now you bid me to tear the light of my eyes. I cannot. I will not. John, you love me yet, no matter what sin it is. John.
Season, Rebecca. My Ruth is bewildered. She cannot eat.
Perhaps she is not hungry yet.
Mr. Paris, I hope you're not going in search of the spirits. I heard promise of that, besides.
There is a wide opinion running through the parish that the devil may be among us. I would satisfy them that they are wrong.
But you come out and call them wrong. Did you consult with the warden, of course, calling the minister to look for devils?
She is not coming to look for devils.
Then what's she coming for?
There be children dying in the village, visitor.
I see none dying. This society will not be a bag for you to swing around your head, Mr. Putnam. Did you call for a meeting before?
I'm sick of meetings. Cannot a man turn his head without he have a meeting?
He may turn his head, but not to hell.
Okay, calm, John. Mr. Paris, I hope you send Marina Hale back as soon as she comes. This will set us all to arguing again with the society. But we thought to have peace this year. I think we ought to rely on the doctor now. And good prayer.
But the doctor's baffled.
If so, he is. Then let us go to God for the cause of it. There's prodigious danger here in seeking of loose spirits. I fear it. Let us rather blame ourselves.
How can we blame ourselves? I, one of 9 sons, the Putnam seed, has peopled this province. And now I have 1 child left of it. And now she shirts.
I cannot fathom that.
Aye, but I must. You think it a work of God to never lose a child or a grandchild, and yet I lose all but one? There are wheels within wheels in this village, and fires within fire.
When Reverend Hale arrives, you will proceed to look for signs of forgement.
You cannot command, Mr. Paris. You vote by name in the society, not by acreage.
I've never heard you so concerned upon this society, Mr. Proctor. I don't think I've seen you a Sabbath meeting since Stoker.
I have trouble enough to ride up from 5 miles to hear him preach on the hellfire and bloody damnation. Take it heart, Mr. Paris. There are many who stay away from church these days because you hardly ever preach of God anymore.
That is a drastic charge.
It's somewhat true. There are many that call to bring the children to
Rebecca,
the church.
Rebecca, it is not the children that I preach for. It is not the children who are unmindful of their obligations to the ministry.
Are they really those unmindful?
I should say, the better half of Salem Village.
And more than that.
And where is my wood? My contract provides that I be supplied with firewood, and I have waited since November for a stick. Even in November, I had to show my frost-bitten hands like some London beggar.
You're allowed $6 a month to buy your wood, Mr. Paris.
I regard that $6 a month as part of my salary. I am paid little enough without I spent $6 on firewood.
60. Plus 6 for firewood.
The salary is $66, Mr. Proctor. I am not some preaching farmer with a book under my arm. I am a graduate of Harvard College.
I am well instructed in arithmetic.
Mr. Corey, you will look far for a man of my kind at $66 per month. I'm not used to this poverty. I left a thrifty business in the Barbados to come serve the Lord. And yet I cannot fathom it. Why am I persecuted here? I cannot offer one proposition, but there be a howling riot of argument. I often have wondered if the devil be in this somewhere. I cannot understand you people otherwise.
Mr. Paris, you are the first minister ever to demand a deed to this house.
Don't a minister deserve a house to live in?
To live in, yes. But to ask ownership is when you shall own the meeting house itself. Last meeting I were at, you spoke so much of deeds and mortgages, I thought I were at an auction.
I want a mark of confidence is all, Mr. Proctor. I am your third preacher in 7 years. You people seem not to understand that I do not wish to be put out like the cat when some majority feels the whip. You fail to comprehend that a preacher is God's man in the parish. A minister is not to be lightly crossed or contradicted.
Ah.
There's either obedience in the church or it will burn like hell is burning.
Can you speak for 1 minute without me laying in hell? I am sick of hell.
It is not for you to say what is good for you to hear.
I must speak my heart, I think.
What are we, Quakers? We are not Quakers here yet, Mr. Proctor, and let you tell that to your followers.
My followers?
Aye, your followers. There's a party here, I'm not blind. There's a faction and a party.
Against you.
Against him. And all of Lord.
Why then? I must find it and join it.
He does not mean that.
He has confessed it.
I mean it solemnly, Rebecca. I like not the smell of his authority.
No, John, you cannot break charity with your minister. You are another kind, John. Clasp his hand and make your peace.
I have cropped his own lump and drag home. What say you, Giles? Let's find that party. He says there's a party.
I've changed my opinion of this man, John. Mr. Paris, I beg your pardon. I never knew you had so much fire in you.
Why, thank you, Giles.
It suggests more of your troubles among the monks of all these years.
Wherefore is everybody suing everybody else? It's a deep thing, dark as a pit. Just last month,
Is it the devil's fault that a man not saying good morning without being clapped for defamation? You are old, Giles. You're not hearing as well as you did.
John Proctor, just last month I collected $9 damages for you publicly saying I'd burn the roof of your house.
I said no such thing. But I paid you for it. So I hope that I would call you deaf without charge. Come along now, Giles. Let me drag my lumber home.
A moment, Mr. Proctor. What is that lumber you're dragging, if I may ask?
My lumber. From my forest by the riverside.
Oh, we've got a while of this here. What anarchy is this? That tract is in my mouth, Mr. Proctor. It's in my mouth!
In your mouth! I bought that tract from Goody Nurse's husband 5 months
well,
ago.
Well, he had no right to sell it. It's clearly my grandfather.
Your grandfather had a habit for willing land that never belonged to him, if I may say it plain.
It's in God's truth. Nearly gave away my north pasture, but I'd break his fingers before we get to it. Come on, John. Let's get that lumber home. You've got a sudden...
One oak of mine, and you'll fight to drag it home.
Aye, and win too, Putnam, this fool and I. Come on.
I'll have my men on you, Corey. I'll clap over it on you.
Hey, someone take these.
Reverend Hand, it is good to see you again.
Wow, he's our hit.
We shall need hard study to come to track down the old boy.
You do come prepared.
You cannot be Rebecca Nurse.
I am, ma'am. Do you know me?
It is strange how I knew you, but I suppose you look as such a good soul should. We have all heard of your great charities in Beverly.
Reverend, have you met this man? Thomas Putnam and his good wife.
Putnam? I had not expected such distinguished company.
It is nothing to help us today. We look to you to save our child.
Your child ails too?
Her soul. Her soul seems blown away. She sleeps in as she walks.
She cannot eat.
Do you men also have afflicted children?
No. These men are just farmers. This is your
farm. You don't believe in witches.
I never spoke on witches one way or the other. You come, Giles.
I have a few queer questions to ask the Reverend. I'll come later.
I've heard you to be a sensible woman, Mrs. Hale. I trust you'll be someone that's safe.
Mrs. Hale, will you look at my daughter, please? She was discovered last night on the high roads. When she slept for the window, she were waving her arms as though she could fly.
Tries to fly?
I'll say this is a notorious sign of witch doctor plot.
No. Now let me instruct you. We cannot look superstition into this. The devil is precise. The marks of his presence are definite as stone. And I must tell you that I shall not proceed unless you are prepared to believe me should I find no bruise of hell upon her.
That is agreed. It is agreed. We will abide by your judgment.
Good then. Now, what were your first warnings of this strangeness?
Well, Mrs. Hale, I discovered her last night, and my niece, and 10 or 12 other girls in the forest, dancing.
You permit dancing?
No, it was secret dancing.
Mr. Paris's housekeeper has knowledge of conjuring.
You cannot be sure of that, Goody Hand.
I know it. I sent my Ruth to Tituba. She should find out who murdered her sisters.
Goody Hand, you set a child to conjure up the dead.
Let God judge me for that. Not you, Rebecca. Not you. I'll not have your judgment anymore. Is it a natural work to lose 7 children before they live a day?
Shh.
7 dead in childbirth.
What was that?
Here lies all the invisible world, caught, defined, and calculated. In these books, the devil stands stripped of all his brute disguises. Here are all your familiar spirits, your incubi, your succubi, your witches that go by land, by air, and by sea, your wizards of the day and of the night. Have no fear now, for we shall find him if he has come among us, and I mean to crush him utterly if he has shown his face.
Will her the child rip?
I cannot tell. She is truly in the devil's grip. We may have to rip and tear to get her free.
I think I'll go then. I'm getting too old for this.
Rebecca, today we may open the boil of all our troubles.
Let us hope for that. Go to God for me, sir.
I hope you don't mean that we go to Satan here.
I wish I knew.
Well, let's get on. Sit you here, Reverend. Reverend Hill, I always wanted to ask a learned person. What is the meaning of these strange books?
What books?
I know not. She hides them.
Who does this?
Martha, my wife. Many a night I wait to see her in the corner reading the book. What do you make of that?
That's not necessarily a...
It discomforts me.
Last night, Marcus, I tried and tried and tried and could not say my prayers. And when she closed her book and left the house, Marcus, I could pray again.
The stoppage of prayer, that is strange. I'll speak further with you on that.
I'm not saying she'd be touched by the devil, but it only reminded her of the book she reads and where she hides them.
We'll discuss it. Now, Mark, the devil is in her, you will witness some frightful wonders in this room. So please keep your wits about you. Putnam, stay close in case she flies. Dear, will you stop? Can you hear me? I am Reverend Hale, minister of Beverly. Do you remember my two little children in Beverly?
How can it be the devil? Why would he choose my house to strike? There are a whole manner of licentious people in this village!
What victory would the devil have to win us all already, Dad? It is the best the devil wants. It was better than the minister.
It's deep, Mr. Barris. Deep, deep.
And the answer, Reverend Hale.
Does someone afflict you, child? It need not be a woman, mind you, or man. Perhaps some bird invisible to others comes to you. Perhaps a mouse, a pig, or any beast at all. Does some figure bid you fly? Nomine Domini Sabbath sui it elic et infernus. Abigail, what sort of dancing were you doing with her in the woods?
Why, common dancing is all.
I ought to say, Mr. Paris told me that he discovered a kettle in the grass. It's true.
Why, that was soup. What kind of soup were in this kettle, Abigail?
Why, beans and lentils.
Mr. Paris, you did not notice, did you, any living things inside this kettle?
I do believe I saw some movement in the kettle.
Why, that jumped in. We never put that in. What jumped in?
My very little frog.
Frog! Abby?
Abigail, it may be your cousin is dying. Did you call the devil last night? Never call no devil. Tituba, Tituba!
She called the devil?
I would like to speak with this Tituba.
Goody Ann, will you bring her up,
How
please?
Did she call him?
I know not. She's from Barbados.
Did you feel any changes when she called him? A sudden cold wind, perhaps, or a trembling below the ground?
So I never saw no devil. Betty, wake up! Betty, Betty!
You cannot evade me, Abigail. Did your cousin drink any of the brew in that kettle last night?
She never drank it.
Did you drink it?
No, ma'am.
Did Tituba ask you to drink it?
She tried, but I refused.
Why are you concealing? Have you sold yourself to Lucifer?
I have not sold myself. I'm a good girl. I'm a proper girl.
She made me do it! She made me do it!
Abby!
She made me drink blood.
What? My baby's blood? No, chicken blood. I gave her chicken blood.
Woman, have you enlisted these children for the devil?
I would never talk with the devil.
Why did you not wake yourself? Are you silencing this child?
Oh, my baby.
You have such a fear upon this child, have you not?
She's gathering
souls for the devil.
Oh, she sends a spirit upon me in church.
She makes me laugh at prayer.
She has often laughed at prayer.
She comes to me at night, and she makes me drink blood.
You beg me, Conjure. You beg me to make those charms.
Sometimes she comes to me and makes me drink corruptions.
Why you say that, Abby?
Sometimes I'll find myself standing in an open doorway without a stitch on my body. And I'll hear her laughing, or singing her Barbados songs.
Yes, Lord, I never...
I want you to wake this child.
I have no power over this child.
You most certainly do, and you will free her from it now. When did you come back with the devil?
I didn't come back with the devil.
You will confess yourself, or I will take you back. No,
she must be dead.
No.
She must
not
be dead.
No,
no,
bind yourselves to hell, it can be very hard to break from it. We are going to help you tear yourself free.
This is Reverend. I do believe somebody else be able to be Martina's children.
Who?
I know not. The devil has numerous witches.
Does he? Now, Chichua, look into me. Come, look into my eyes. Oh, you would be a good Christian woman, would you not, Chichua?
I am a good Christian woman.
Love these children.
I would never do anything to hurt these little children.
But you love God, Tituba.
I love God with all my being.
And in his holy name.
Bless him, bless him.
To his glory.
Eternal glory, bless him, bless the Lord.
Open yourself, Tituba. Open yourself and let God's light shine on you.
Bless the Lord.
When the devil comes, does he ever come with another person? Someone in the village, someone you know.
Who'll come with him? Is it man or woman?
Sarah did there? Or Osborne?
Man or woman? It was woman.
Woman? You said a woman. What? Woman!
I know not. It was black, dark.
You didn't see him. Why could you not see her?
They were always talking, running around and screaming.
Witches? Out of Salem. Salem witches.
I believe so, yes, sir.
How many came with him to Cuba? Two, three, four, how many?
Their names!
Four. There was four.
Their names.
How many times have you bid me kill you, Mr. Paris? And I say, you lie, devil, you lie. And he comes to me on a stormy night. And he say, look at these people who belong to me. And there I see Sarah Good.
Sarah Good?
Aye, sir. And Goody Osborne.
I knew it. I knew it. Goody Osborne were midwife to me 3 times, and I begged you, Thomas, did I not? I begged you not to call her. My babies would shrivel in her hands.
Tituba, you must take courage. Tell us all of their names. How can you bear to see this child suffering? Look at her, Tituba. Look at her God-given innocence. Her soul is so frail. We must protect her. Open yourself, Tituba, and God will bless you for it.
I want to confess myself. I want to go back to God. I want the sweet love of Jesus. I saw the devil. I wrote in his book, I danced with the devil. I want to go back to Jesus. I want to kiss his hand. I saw Goody Goody with the devil. I saw Goody Osborne with the devil. I saw Bridget Bishop with the devil.
I saw George Jacobs with the devil. I saw Goody Howe with the devil.
She speaks.
I saw Goody Zimmer with the devil.
I saw Goody Powell with the devil.
I'll call the marshal.
I saw Goody Osborne with the devil.
I saw Goody
Osborne
with the devil. I saw Goody Cook with the devil.
I saw Goody Zimmer with the devil.
George Jacobs happen. How'd that please you?
I would.
I mean to please you, Elizabeth.
I know it, John.
you lock the farm with me? I've never seen such a load of flowers on the earth. Lilacs have a purple smell. But the smell of nightfall, I think. Massachusetts is a beauty in the spring.
Aye, it is.
I think you're sad again. Are you?
You come so late, I thought you'd gone to Salem this afternoon.
Why? I have no business in Salem.
You did speak of going earlier this week.
I thought better of it since.
Mary Warren's there today.
Why'd you let her go? You heard me forbid her to go to Salem anymore.
I couldn't stop her.
It's a fault. A fault. You were the mistress of this house, not Mary Warren.
She frightened all my strength away.
How did that mouse frighten you, Elizabeth?
It is a mouse no more. I forbid her go, and she raises up her chin like the daughter of a prince and says to me, I must go to Salem, Goody Proctor. I am an official of the court.
Court? What court?
Aye, it's a proper court they have now. They've sent four judges out of Boston, she said. Witty magistrates of the general court, and at the heads is the deputy governor.
But she's mad.
I would to God she were. There'll be 14 people in the jail now, she says. And they'll be tried, and the court have the power to hang them too, she says.
They never hang.
The deputy governor promised hanging if they'll not confess, John. The town's gone wild, I think. She speaks of Abigail, and I thought she were sick to hear her. Abigail brings the other girls into the court, and where she walks, the crowd will part like the sea for Israel. And the folks are brought before them, and if they scream and howl and fall to the floor, the person's clapped in jail for bewitching them.
Black mischief.
I would go to Salem, John. I think you must. You must tell them it is a fraud.
Aye. It is. It is surely.
Let you go to Ezekiel Cheever. He knows you well. And tell them what she said to you in her uncle's house last week. She said it had not to do with witchcraft, did she not?
Aye. She did. She did.
God forbid you keep that from your court, John. I think they must be told.
Aye. Must. It is a wonder they do believe her.
I would go to Salem now, John. Let you go tonight.
I'll think on it.
You cannot keep it, John.
I know I cannot keep it. I say I will think on it.
Good then. Let you think on it.
I only wonder how I'm going to prove what she told me, Elizabeth. The girl's a saint now. I think it got easy to prove her fraud. The town got so silly. She told it to me in a room alone. I have no proof for it.
You were alone with her?
For a moment alone, I...
Why did it not as you told me?
For a moment, I say. The others come in soon after.
Do as you wish, then.
Woman! I will not have this suspicion anymore.
I have not.
I'll not have it.
Then let you not earn it.
You doubt me yet?
John, if it were not Abigail, you must go to her. Would you falter now? I think not.
Now look, you.
I see what I see, John.
You will not judge me anymore, Elizabeth. I have good reason to think before I charge fraud on Abigail. I will think on it. Let you look to your own improvement before you judge your husband further. I have forgotten Abigail.
And I?
Oh, spare! You forget nothing and forgive nothing. Have charity, woman. I've got tiptoe around this house all 7 months since she's been gone. I've not moved from there to there without anything to please you. Knit. An everlasting funeral marches around your heart. I cannot speak for I am doubted. Every moment, judge the lies though I walk into a courtroom when I come into this house.
John, you are not open with me. You saw
me. I'll believe my honesty no more, Elizabeth.
John, I'm
open. No more! I should have roared you down when you first told me your suspicion. But I willed it. I'm not a Christian. I confessed. Confessed! Some dream I had must have mistaken you for God that day. But you're not, Elizabeth. You're not. And let me remember that. You look for the good in me. Judge me not.
I do not judge you. The magistrate sits in your heart that judges you. I never thought you were a good man, John. Only some of you older.
Oh, Elizabeth, your justice can freeze beer.
go to Salem when I forbid it. Do you mock me? I will whip you if you dare leave this house again! When will you proceed to keep this house I paid you $9 a month to do? And my wife not wholly well?
I made you a gift today, dear Proctor. I had to sit long hours in a chair and pass the time with sewing.
Why, thank you. It's a fair profit.
We must all love each other now, Lady Proctor.
Aye, indeed we must.
I'll get up early in the morning and clean the house and I'm asleep now.
Mary. True? Are you 14 women arrested?
No, sir. I'm 39 now. What ails you, child? Goody Osborne will hang.
Hey! Hang, you say? And the deputy governor will admit.
She sentenced her. She must, but not Sarah Good. Sarah Good confessed.
Confess? To what?
That she sometimes made a compact with Lucifer and wrote her name in his black book with her blood and bound herself to torment Christians till God's thrown down and we must all worship hell forevermore.
Surely, what a jabberer she is.
Mr. Proctor, in open court, she near choked us all to death.
How choked you?
She sent her spirit out.
Oh, Mary, Mary.
She tried to kill me many times, Lady Proctor.
Why, I've never heard you mention that before.
Well, I never knew it before. I never knew anything before. When she come into the court, I say to myself, you must not accuse this woman, for she sleep in ditches and is so very old and poor. But then she sit there, denying, and I feel a misty coldness climbing up my back, and the skin on my skull begin to creep, and I feel a clamber on my neck, and I cannot breathe air. And then I hear a voice, a screaming voice, and it were my voice, and suddenly I remember everything she had done to me.
Why? What did she do to you?
So many a time, Mr. Proctor, she had come to this very door, begging bread, a cup of cider, and mark this. Whenever I turned her way empty, she mumbled.
Mumbled?
She may mumble if she's hungry.
Aye, but what does she mumble?
You must remember, Lady Proctor, last month, a Monday, I think, I turned her away and I thought my guts would burst for 2 days after. Do you remember it?
Why, I do, I think.
And so that's... I told that to Judge Hathorne, and he asks her so. Lady Osborne, says he, what curse do you mumble that this girl must fall sick after turning you away? And she replies,
why, Your Excellency, no curse at all. I only say my commandments. I hope I may say my commandments, says she.
And that's an upright answer. Aye, but then Judge Hathorne's sake, recite for her commandments. And of all the 10, she could not say a single one. She never knew no commandments, and they had her in flat lie.
And so condemned her?
Why, they must when she condemned herself.
The proof, the proof!
I told you the proof. It's hard for me, quite as rough the judges say.
You will not go to court again, Mary Warren.
I must tell you, sir, I will be gone every day now. I am amazed you do not see what weighty work we do.
What work you do? It is strange work for a Christian girl to hang old women.
Mr. Proctor will not hang them if they confess. Sarah Good will only sit in jail for some time. Here's a wonder for you, think on this. Goody Good is pregnant.
Pregnant? Are they mad? The woman's near to 60.
They had Dr. Griggs examine her, and she's full to the brim. Been smoking a pipe all these years and no husband either, but she's safe, thank God. Will not hurt the innocent child. Be that not a marvel, sir. You must see it. It's God's work we do. So, I will be gone every day for some time. I am an official of the court, they say.
For all officials,
I'm not stand whipping anymore.
You're in close now.
The devil holds in sale, Mr.
Oh, with the devil out of here!
Your life today!
I'm accused. Someone mentioned. But I said I never saw no sign you ever sent your spirit out to hurt no one. And seeing as I did it so close with you, they dismissed me. Who accused me? I am bound by law. I cannot tell it. I only hope you'll not be so sarcastical with me no more. 4 judges and the deputy governor sat to dinner with us but an hour ago. I would have you speak civilly to me from this out.
Go to bed.
I'll not be ordered to bed no more, Mr. Proctor. I'm 18 and a woman, however single.
If you wish to sit up, then sit up.
I wish to go to bed.
Good night, then.
Good night.
Oh, the noose is up.
There'll be no noose.
She wants me dead. I knew all week it would come to this.
They dismissed it. You heard us.
And what of tomorrow? She will cry me out until they take.
must be wise, Elizabeth.
Oh, indeed, indeed.
You're nothing. I'll find Ezekiel Cheaton. I'll tell him she told me we're all sport.
John, with so many in the jail, more than Cheever's help is needed now, I think. Would you favor me this? Go to Abigail.
What am I to say to Abigail?
John, grant me this. You have a faulty understanding of young girls. There's a promise made in anything.
What promise?
Spoke or silent, a promise is surely made. She may dote on it now. I'm sure she does. It takes to kill me than to take my place. It's her dearest hope, John. I know it. There'd be a thousand names. Why does she call mine? I'm no goody-good who sits in ditches, nor Osborne drunk and half-witted. She dare not call it such a farmer's wife unless there be monstrous profit in it. She thinks to take my place, John.
She cannot think it.
John, have you ever shown her someone of contempt? She cannot pass you in the church, but you will blush.
I blush for my sin.
I think she sees another meaning in that blush.
What see you? What see you, Elizabeth?
I think you'd be somewhat ashamed, for I am there and she's so close.
Oh, when will you know me, woman? If I was stoned, I would have cracked for shame this 7 months.
Then go and tell her she's a whore. Whatever promise she may sense, break it, John, break it.
Good then. I'll go.
Oh, how unwillingly.
I will curse her harder than the oldest cinder in hell. But pray, begrudge me not my anger.
Your anger? I only ask you.
Woman! Am I so base? Do you truly think me base?
I never called you base.
Then why do you charge me such a promise? A promise that a stallion gives a man that I gave that girl.
Then why are you angry with me when I bid you?
Because it speaks deceit and I am honest. I plead no more, Elizabeth. I see now that your spirit twists around the single error of my life and I will never tear it free.
You'll tear it free when you come to know that I will be your only wife or no wife at all. She has an arrow in you yet, John Proctor, and you know it well.
Good evening.
Sam. Good evening. Come in.
I hope I did not startle you.
No, it's only that I heard no car.
You are good with Proctor?
Aye. Elizabeth.
I hope you are not off to bed yet.
No, no. It's only that we're not used to visitors after dark. You are welcome here. You sit me down, Mrs. Sale.
I will. Let you sit, good wife Proctor.
Can I give you a drink, Reverend?
No, no. I am further traveling yet tonight. Now, I'll not keep you long, but I have some business with you.
Business of the court?
No, no. I come with my own, without the court's authority. Hear me. I know not if you're aware, but your wife's name is mentioned in the court.
I know of it. Our Mayor Warren told us. We're entirely amazed.
I'm a stranger here, as you know, and in my ignorance I find it hard to draw a clear opinion of them who come accused before the court. And so this afternoon and now tonight, I go from house to house. I come now from Rebecca Nurse's house.
Rebecca's charged?
God forbid such a one be charged. She is, however, mentioned somewhat.
You cannot believe, I hope, that Rebecca trafficked with the devil.
Woman, it is possible.
But surely you cannot think so.
These are strange times, sir. No man may longer doubt that the powers of darkness are gathered in a monstrous attack upon this village. There's too much evidence now to deny it. Who will agree, sir?
I have no knowledge yet. I think it hard. So pious a woman. He's secretly a devil's bitch after 7 years of such good prey.
Aye, but the devil is a wily one. You cannot deny it. However, she is far from accused, and I know she will not be. I thought, sir, to put some question on the Christian character of this house, if you'll permit me.
Why? Have no fear of questions, ma'am.
Good, then. Now, I notice that in the Book of Records, Mr. Paris keeps, you are rarely in the church on Sabbath day.
No, ma'am, you are mistaken.
26 times in 17 months, sir, I must call that rare. Will you tell me why you're so absent?
Never do I must account to that man before I come to church or stay at home. My wife was sick this winter.
So I have been told, but you, sir, why could you not come alone?
I surely came when I could, when I could not. Pray in this house.
Your house is not a church, sir. Your theology must tell you that.
Aye, it does. And it tells me that a minister may pray to God without giving golden candlesticks upon the altar.
What golden candlesticks?
Ever since the church were built, there lay pewter candlesticks upon the altar. Francis Nurse made them, you see. No sweeter hands have ever touched the metal. When Paris comes, and for 20 weeks, he preached nothing but golden candlesticks until he got them. Now, I lay with the earth from the dawn of day to the bleak of night, and I tell you truth. When I look to heaven and see my money glaring at his elbows, it hurt my prayer, man. It hurt my prayer.
And yet, a Christian on Sabbath day must be in church. Tell me, you have three children.
Aye.
How comes it that only two are baptized?
I like it not that Mr. Paris lay his hand upon my baby. I see no light of God in that man, and I'll not conceal it.
I must say, sir, that that is not for you to decide. The man's ordained, therefore the light of God is in him.
What is your suspicion, Mrs. Hale?
No, I have no suspicion.
I nailed the roof upon the church. I hung the door.
That's a good sign, then.
Maybe I've been too quick to bring the man's book. Surely you cannot think that we desire the destruction of religion. I think that is in your mind, is it not?
There is a softness in your record, sir. Softness.
I think perhaps we may have been too harsh with Mr. Paris. I think so. But sure we never loved the devil here.
Do you know your commandments, Elizabeth?
I surely do. There be no more complaint upon my life, Mrs. Hale. I'm a covenanted Christian woman.
Sir? I'm sure I do.
Let you recite them for me, if you will.
The commandments.
Aye.
Thou shalt not kill.
Aye.
Thou shalt not steal. Thou shalt not covet thy neighbor's goods, nor make unto thee any graven image. Thou shalt not take the name of the Lord in vain. I shall have no other God before me. I shall remember the Sabbath day and keep it holy. I shall honor thy mother and father. I shall not bear false witness. I shall not make unto thee any graven image.
You have said that one twice, sir.
Aye.
Adultery, John.
Aye. You see, ma'am, between the two of us, we do know them all. I think it'd be a small fault.
Theology, sir, is a fortress. No kind of fortress may be held as strong.
There be no love for Satan in this house, ma'am.
I pray it. Pray it dearly. I'll meet you tonight.
Mrs. Hale, I do think you are suspecting me somewhat, are you not?
Good wife, Proctor. I cannot judge you. My duty is to add my name to the godly wisdom of the court. I wish you both good health and good fortune. Good night.
I think you must tell her, John.
What is that? Will you please tell her?
I have no witnesses, and I cannot prove it. Except my word be taken. But I know the children's sickness have not to do with witchcraft.
Not to do with
witchcraft. Mr. Paris discovered them sporting in the woods.
Who told you this?
Abigail Williams.
Abigail Williams?
Aye.
Abigail Williams said it had not to do with witchcraft?
She told me the day you came, ma'am.
Well, why have you kept this?
I never knew until tonight that the world had gotten so daft with this nonsense.
Nonsense? Sir, I myself have examined Tituba, Sarah Good, and numerous others who have confessed to dealing with the devil. They have confessed it.
And why not? Then they'll hang for denying it. There are them who will swear to anything before they hang. Have you not thought of that?
I have indeed. And you would testify to this in the court.
I have not reckoned in going to court, but if I must, I will.
Do you falter here?
I falter nothing. I do wonder how my story may be credited in such a court. I do wonder when such a steady-headed minister as you would suspicion such a woman who has never lied and cannot lie. And the whole world knows she cannot lie. I may falter somewhat. I'm no fool.
Proctor, let you be open with me, for I have a rumor that troubles me. It's said you hold no belief that there may even be witches in this world. Is this true?
I have often wondered if there be witches on this earth. But I do not think they are among us now.
Then you do not believe.
I have no knowledge in it. The Bible says there be witches. I'll not deny them.
to you, ma'am?
I cannot believe it.
You cannot?
Elizabeth, you bewilder her.
I cannot believe the devil may own a woman's soul, Mrs. Hale, when she has kept in upright ways I have. I'm a good woman, I know it. If you think that I may do only good work in the world, and yet be secretly bound to Satan, then I must tell you, ma'am, I do not believe it.
So you do not believe there are witches?
If you think that I am one, I say there are none.
Gospel woman, surely you do not fight against the gospel.
She believe in the gospel, every word.
Question Abigail Williams about the gospel, not myself.
She do not mean to doubt the gospel, ma'am. This is a Christian house. A Christian house.
God keep you both. Let the third child be baptized quickly and go you without fail to an each Sunday Sabbath prayer. Keep a quiet, solemn way about you. I think it would be best for you to stay.
John! Giles, what's the matter?
They take my wife and his Rebecca.
Rebecca's in jail?
Aye, Chief will come and take her and his wife. We've only just now come from the jail, and they won't even let us in to see them.
They've surely gone wild now, Mrs. Hale.
Reverend Hale, surely you can speak to the deputy governor about this.
Hey, calm yourself, nurse.
My wife is the very brick and mortar of the church, Mrs. Hale. And Martha Corey, no woman can be yet closer to God than Martha.
How is Rebecca charged?
For murder, she's charged. For the marvelous and supernatural murder of Goody Putnam's babies. What am I to do, Miss Sale?
Nurse, believe me, Rebecca's tainted. There's nothing to stop a whole green world from burning. Let you rest in the judgment of the court. The court will send her home, I know it.
You cannot mean she'll be tried in court.
Nurse, though our hearts may break, we cannot falter. These are new times, and there's a misty plot afoot so subtle it should be criminal to hold to old respects and ancient friendships. I've seen too many frightful groups of it in the court. The devil is alive in Salem, and we tear up fail wherever the accusing finger points.
How may such a woman murder children?
Man, you must remember that until an hour before the devil fell, God thought him to be beautiful in heaven.
I never marked my wife for a witch. I only said she read books.
Mr. Corey, what exactly complaint has been made upon your wife?
That bloody mongrel Walcott charged here. You see, he bought a pig off my wife 4 or 5 years ago, and the pig died soon after. And so he comes dancing for his money back, and my wife says, well, God, if you're going to live to be a pig, you won't live to own any. And he goes to court saying from that day to this, he can't keep a pig alive for more than 4 weeks, because my wife's witching him with her books.
Good evening to you, Proctor. Mr. Cheever. Good evening.
Good evening, all.
Good evening, Mrs. Hale. I hope you're not here at business of the court.
I am, Proctor. I'm a clerk of the court now, you know.
Tis a pity, Ezekiel, that an honest tailor such as you going to heaven will be going to hell. You'll burn for this and you know it.
You yourself know I must do as I'm told. You surely know that, Giles. Not as if you'd not be sending me to hell. I like not the sound of it, I tell you. I like not the sound of it. Now believe me, Proctor. How heavy be the law, all its tonnage I do carry on my back tonight. I have a warrant for your wife.
You said she were not charged!
No, nothing of it. When were she charged?
I am giving 16 more tonight and she is one.
Who charged her?
Why, Abigail Williams charged her.
On what proof? What proof?
Mr. Proctor, I have little time. The court bid me to search your house, but I do not like to search a house. So can you hand me any poppets your wife may keep here?
Poppets?
I never kept no poppets, not since I were a girl.
I spy a poppet, Goody Proctor.
That's Mary's. Has the court discovered a text in poppets now?
Do you keep any others in this house?
No. Nor this one until tonight. What signifies a poppet?
Why a poppet? Poppet may signify. Now, woman, would you please to come with me?
She will not. Fetch Mary here.
No, I'm forbidden to leave her out of my sight.
You will leave her out of sight and out of mind. Fetch Mary, Elizabeth.
What signifies the poppet, Mr. Cheever?
Why, they say a poppet may signify that she. Why?
What's this?
Why? It is a needle!
Herrick,
it is a needle!
What signifies a needle?
This go hard with her, Proctor, this.
I had my doubts, Proctor. I had my doubts. But here's calamity. You see it? It is a needle.
What meaning has it?
Why, the girl, the Williams girl, Abigail Williams, she sat to dinner in Reverend Paris's house tonight. And without a word nor warning, she falls to the floor like a struck beast, he says, and scream to scream a bull would weep to hear. And going to save her, stuck 2 inches in the flesh of her belly, he draws out a needle. And demanding of how she so be stabbed, she testified with your wife's familiar spirit who pushed it in.
She did that herself. I hope you're not taking this for proof, ma'am.
'Tis hard proof. I find here a poppy goody Proctor keeps. I have found it, ma'am, and in the belly a needle is stuck. I tell you, true Proctor, I never warranted to see such proof of hell, and I bid you, obstruct me not.
Hear that! Mary, have this poppet come into my house.
What poppet's that, sir?
This poppet!
I believe it is mine, sir.
It is your poppet, is it not?
It is.
And how did it come into this house?
I made it in the court and gave it to Goody Proctor tonight.
Now, ma'am, you have it?
Mary Warren, a needle has been found stabbed into this poppet.
Well, I meant no harm by it.
You stuck it in yourself?
Aye.
What say you now?
Mary, are you certain this be your natural memory? May it be possible that someone conjures you even now as you say this.
Conjures me? Why, no, I am entirely myself, I think. Let you ask Susanna Walcott. She saw me naked in the court. Ask Abby. Abby sat beside me while I was sewing.
Bid him be gone, Mrs. Hale. His mind is surely made. Bid him out.
What signifies a needle?
Abigail, you charge a cold and cruel murder on Abigail Williams.
Murder? I charge no one.
Abigail? We're stabbed tonight. A needle was found stuck into her belly.
And she charges me!
Aye.
Why, the girl is murder! She must be ripped out of the world!
You've heard that! Ripped out of the world! Herod, you heard it! Out! You dare not touch the ward!
Out with you!
You ripped the deputy governor's ward, man!
Get the deputy governor out of my house!
Proctor!
Get you done with them! You are a broken minister!
Proctor, if she is innocent...
If she is innocent, why have you never wanted her parents to be innocent? Or Abigail? Is the accuser always holy now? Were they born this morning as clean as God's fingers? I'll tell you what's walking Salem. Vengeance is walking Salem. We are as we always were. Except the little, crazy children jingle the keys to the kingdom, and common vengeance writes the law. That warrant is vengeance. I will not give my wife to vengeance.
Oh, John.
You will not go.
I have that man outside. You cannot keep her. The law binds me, John. I cannot budge.
You will see her taken?
Proctor, the court is...
Pontius Pilate! God will not let you wash your hands of this!
John, I think I must go with them. Mary, there's bread enough for the morning. You will bake in the afternoon. Help Mr. Proctor as you were his own daughter. You owe me that and much more. When the children wake, speak nothing of witchcraft. It will frighten them.
I will bring you home, Elizabeth. I will bring you soon.
John, bring me soon.
I will fall like an ocean on that court. Fear nothing, Elizabeth.
I will fear nothing. Tell the children I've gone to visit someone sick.
Yet silent, minister? It is fraud. Fraud, and you know it. Where do you stand, woman?
Proctor.
Out of my sight.
Charity, Proctor. Charity. What I have heard in her favor, I will not be afraid to testify in court. God help me, I cannot judge her guilty or innocent, I know not, but only this consider. The world goes mad, and in profit nothing, you should lay the blame to the vengeance of a little girl.
You are a coward! Will you be ordained in the tears of God? You are a coward now!
Proctor, I cannot think that God be so greatly provoked by such a petty cause. We must think of the cause proportionate. Were there murder done, never brought to light, abomination, some secret blasphemy that sinks to heaven? Think on cause, man, and let you help me discover it. For that is your way, believe it. That is your only way when the world sinks to such confusion. Counsel among yourselves. Think on yourselves and think
on your village and what may have brought such a thundering wrath upon you all. Pray God open our eyes.
Why, I never heard of no murder done in Salem.
Leave me, Francis. Leave me.
Tell me, John, are we lost?
Go home now, Giles. Speak on it tomorrow.
We'll come early, eh?
Aye. Go now, Giles. Slide together in our pit. You will tell the court what you know.
I cannot, they'll turn on me.
My wife will not die for me. I will put your guts into your mouth, and that goodness will not die for me.
I cannot do what I want.
Make your peace with it. Now, hell and heaven, grapple on our backs and all old pretenses ripped away. Make your peace with it. God's icy wind will blow.